Hey y'all, it is literally the last day of the year, and as I'm on my walk run, this is what I see. Can y'all see that? Ambulance, fire department. Somebody's not doing too well this morning. I'm praying for them and anyone else who is not feeling well or who has lost someone already. 2021 has been as unpredictable as 2020 was. And so I'm wondering how you're doing and what your plans are for this weekend, tonight. And more than anything, more than resolutions and intentions, I just really hope that you value and own your worth and your story to be a blessing to somebody else going into this new year. That what you are going through, what you have gone through, is it makes you who you are. As hard as it is, as much as we wish it didn't happen the way that it did, it makes you, or it isn't happening the way that it's happening, it makes you who you are, and you are amazing. You are a miracle. You are a wonder. And because you are all of those things, it's up to you to own it. It's still true that you are those things, but they don't get manifested and multiplied and magnified in the world if you don't own them. They just sit inside of you laying dormant if you don't own your awesomeness. And so owning your awesomeness is not being vain. It's not being cocky. It's not the antithesis to being a good Christian. It's none of that. It is literally being courageous enough and confident enough to move forward and take risks and speak up, use your voice, take risks to give love and receive love, take risks to stand out, to be light. Like, all of those things takes you sucking up any fear and doubt that you might have about uncertainties and literally owning your value. I pray that for you in this new year. And it is a journey. We pick ourselves back up and keep it moving. I am 47 years old and I'm still learning that consistency and discipline is my birthright. I get to be consistent and disciplined to take care of me for me. And it's in that that I'm able to be a blessing to other people so that I don't end up in one of those ambulance cars and everybody crying over me, but I'm not here anymore, you know? So I love you guys. Happy New Year. Happy New Year. I'm praying that it is joyous for you. And if it is not joyous for whatever reason, whether it is loneliness or grief or loss or fear or doubt, I'm praying that you process it in a way that allows you to move forward and know that whatever you feel like you are lacking, that you have what it takes inside of you to fill that void. Nobody else needs to fill it outside of you. No other activity, no job, no marital status, no amount of money. Nothing can fill that void but you. And God has already given you the tools. God is already inside of you. So I'm not saying void of God. God is inside of you already. So you have everything inside of you that you need to fill any voids, to fill any voids that you feel. I love you guys. Take care. Happy New Year. I'll see you on the other side.